Did you know that in Denmark, power outages only occur for about 20 minutes a year? Compared to the United States, where power outages average up to 4 hours a year, this is quite exceptional. But for Denmark, which has the world's highest ranking energy system, this outstanding feat is no surprise. As Asher Naim Karesh, clean tech team leader for Invest in Denmark, explains it, the country's excellent energy system is due to the extensive undergrounding of low and medium voltage power lines, which makes the Danish power grid robust. Denmark is set to create the world's first offshore energy island. This artificial island is to be located in the North Sea, and is projected to cost about $34 billion. That is about equal to the annual budget of some countries. So why is Denmark building this green island? Welcome to Posh Future. In this video, we'll be taking a look at some of the cool facts about the world's first energy island. Don't forget to hit the subscribe button and turn on your post notifications. It's free. Denmark began oil exploration in 1972, and its revenues helped make it one of the richest countries in Europe. However, in December 2020, after a vote taken in the Danish parliament, Europe's biggest oil producer put an end to further oil and gas exploration in the North Sea. The country has 55 other oil and gas platforms, which will still be allowed to operate. In 2019 alone, Denmark produced approximately 103,000 barrels of oil and gas a day, so the decision to end further exploration will cost the European nation a painful $2 billion in lost revenue. However, this is a watershed moment, as put by Helen Hagel of Greenpeace Denmark. The milestone decision will allow Denmark to assert itself as a green frontier and inspire other countries to end our dependency on climate-wrecking fossil fuels. Pursuing this, the country is on an ambitious mission to become CO2 neutral by 2050, and the Energy Island is a tool to accomplishing this goal. The Danish Energy Association says that it plans to have 1 million electric cars 12 years from now, and increase the amount of heat pumps. This isn't the first time Denmark is taking the initiative in pioneering an ambitious project. Almost 30 years ago, the country built the world's first offshore wind farm on the Danish island of Lolland, just off the coast of Vinby, a town in Denmark. So let's talk about a few cool facts with regard to this artificial island. Number 1. Extremely large capacity. The island is slated to power at least 3 million households in Europe. With Denmark's population at approximately 6 million people, the power capacity is quite a feat. Even more amazing is the fact that the project is not only limited to Denmark, but other surrounding countries. In fact, the project is situated in the North Sea, off the country's west coast, and will connect to several European countries. According to Professor Jacob Istegard, who has the Center for Electric Power and Energy at the Technical University of Denmark, it is and will be a cornerstone in the green transition and the reduction of Danish CO2 emissions. Though it's not set in stone, the professor mentioned the UK, Germany, and the Netherlands as possible partners, citing that the project is going to be an international effort. Number 2. A town at sea. The Energy Island will be as big as 120,000 square meters, that is proportionate to the size of 18 football fields put together. Yet that's not the least of it, as the Danish government hopes to further increase the size of the artificial island to nearly 4 times that figure. It might later be expanded to 460,000 square meters. How many football fields is that? Help us do the math. Number 3. Wind power. This project is set to harness the power of the wind, which is usually stronger around the sea. The island will be powered by 200 massive wind turbines, supplying and storing completely green energy. The North Sea, where the island will be built, has the potential for offshore wind as high as 180 gigawatts. However, this green island will initially supply 3 gigawatts, later to be increased to a capacity of 10 gigawatts. What this means for the future of energy production is that all coal-fired power plants might eventually be shut down. This will be an enormous landmark moment for green energy. Number 4. Largest project in Danish history. This project is apparently the largest and most expensive project ever carried out in the history of Denmark. They are sparing no expense, as the island is slated to cost about $34 billion, equivalent to 210 billion Danish kroner. Number 5. Private and public sector partnership. Though the project will be partly owned by the Danish government and partly owned by the private sector as well, the government will be the majority stakeholder, but will create room for private partners. There is little information so far on how the partnership will be handled or the criteria for partners. Number 6. Location. Though there is no specific information on the exact location of the island, it is a well-known fact that it will be located just 80 kilometers off the west coast. Number 7. Carbon neutrality. Compared to its European neighbor, Germany, which possesses CO2 emissions reaching a peak of 683.8 million metric tons, Denmark has reduced its carbon footprint by almost 50%. From 62 million metric tons in 2003, the numbers have dropped to an impressive 33 million tons as of 2019. The country plans to reduce its carbon emissions by 70% by 2030, compared to the levels at 1990. With about 47% of the country's energy being harnessed from wind power, they are certainly leading the charge towards a green future. Number 8. Smaller islands. Another smaller energy island is also in the works. This island will produce 2 gigawatts, 1 gigawatt less than the North Sea plant. It will be situated off Bornholm to the east of mainland Denmark. Agreements have already been signed for electricity to be provided from there to Germany, Belgium, and the Netherlands. According to Lars Osgaard, the country, though proud of the international recognition, is not going to rest on their laurels. In future, they plan to strengthen both their electricity grid and support flexibility for consumers. By 2030, they plan to generate 55% of their energy from renewable resources. The country has also signed an energy agreement, backed by the support of the Danish Parliament, to strengthen energy and climate goals. Denmark is a worthy icon in the international struggle against climate change. So that wraps it up for our list of cool facts about the world's first energy island. Hope you enjoyed watching. If you did, punch the like button to show us some love. Subscribe and turn on your post notifications so you never miss a video. See you next time.